Hi, I'm Simon from The Red Ferret, and winter is coming, so that means you'll need to stay inside and watch some television or something that can project something. This is the Ori Mag P6 Smart Projector from GearBest, and it's a very small projector which can be used in your room, on your wall, on a projection screen, anywhere you want. We have the projector itself. It's a small black box with some buttons, which I'll go over in a minute. And then in the other boxes, we have a carrying pouch, and a stand for the projector as well, which is actually pretty neat. We have an IC adapter, what's this? Oh, okay, so this is a micro USB input for the projector itself, which is used for one input for charging and one input, the other one for inputting a USB device. And in this box, you just have a regular micro USB to USB cable for charging. Then we have a micro USB cable to USB for inputting a USB unit. And with this one, you can do both at the same time. And then this is a stand for the projector. So what do we have? We have the lens over here, of course. We have some buttons over here. You probably can't see those, but there are some small arrows and a back button over here and a select button over here. And this is also a button for powering it on. The reset button, micro USB input. There's even auxiliary input as well. Micro SD card and the focus ring for focusing. So we'll turn this thing on and let's see how it looks. All right, so as you can already see, I had to make a construction so it would project on the screen. But as you can see in lighting conditions where there's low light or a lot of light, it won't really work that well. Yeah, so I'm going to put the lights out and give a demonstration on this thing.
Secret of Mana, Earthbound, Punch-Out, Kirby, and some others, of course, Zelda as well. Let's see, I'm very excited for this thing. It's just nostalgia. It's so... It's back. I always love things from Nintendo. It's a different experience. So what we have in the box is, of course, a manual, which doesn't do that long. It's not longer. Weather resistant, if I'm not mistaken, yes, IP67 weather resistant. It has 12 hours of playback time, a built-in noise cancelling speakerphone as well, and yeah, it's shockproof and all those things. So
Alright, so it's a little bit messy over here, but after a big test, I can actually see that this can be pretty useful in some cases. For example, if you're looking for something to view YouTube videos in your bed, for example, on your wall, on your top wall. I have no idea how you say that in English, but you know what I mean. And yeah, for that, it's actually pretty cool. You saw it in my bed. It was actually pretty neat to watch YouTube videos from my ceiling. It's a ceiling, probably, yeah. One thing I have to say is that when the Wi-Fi connection is not that good, you get jittery all over the video, as you could see. I had it when I used the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi internet. I didn't have it at first with the 5.0, but the Wi-Fi reach in my room is very terrible. So downstairs, I don't have those jittery things, but it's still pretty good. Other positive things about the P6 is that it's very small and portable, as you can see. It's also perfect for small projections. You can go very wide, very big, but it won't be that sharp anymore. So for small, regular projections, it's perfect. It's actually pretty neat that you can project your computer or your iPhone via this thing. That's actually pretty cool. Of course, there are various options. I also tried the OTG thing. It didn't work. I don't know what I did wrong. I used the instructions from the manual. Didn't work. So I have an iPhone SE. Didn't work. It worked via the casting thing, via Wi-Fi, so that's all good. I also tried the micro SD input. You have to use specific videos in order to get them played, but I think the streaming via the phone is the easiest option to do this. Of course, this thing won't be very useful if you want to watch a full HD movie with stereo surround with this thing. No, this is for watching YouTube videos or for doing something at your work, for example. If you want to project the screen from your computer, if you're at work and you want to show something, then this is actually pretty neat for that. It's also pretty sharp. It's not 4K projecting that you see, but it's more than decent. It's LCD, so it's more than decent. The speaker, as you could hear, is also pretty good, actually. I wasn't expecting a speaker like that. It sounds pretty nice. It's not tinny or canny or sharp. It's actually pretty good, and it's pretty loud as well, because the motor inside this thing, or the vent, is pretty loud, so you need to compensate that with a loudspeaker. Last weird thing I actually saw on this thing is that it creates Wi-Fi. So it creates a Wi-Fi spot for your phone, which you can use. There's no password whatsoever, so yeah, that can be dangerous. But I connected to this Wi-Fi thing and I could surf the web on my phone via the Wi-Fi over here on this thing. So this connects to my Wi-Fi downstairs, and then this broadcasts a Wi-Fi signal, probably. I don't know how it works. So negative things: you need to have good Wi-Fi, as I already mentioned, so yeah, that will be important. The OTG cable doesn't work with me. I don't know if it works with you. It doesn't work with me. Battery life also not that good. I would say about 1 or 1.5 hours, probably. I didn't test it that long, but I could see that it drains a lot of battery. It's very small, so yeah, you could expect that. But of course, you can charge it while it's projecting, so yeah, that's actually a solution for the problem over there. Other thing is that when you project from your phone, it's all sharp, it's all good, but when you project from your MacBook, for example, or from your computer, or etc., the text on the projection is not good. You can't read small texts, as you can see from this video. And yeah, that's not good. That's just not nice. So from an iPhone, works perfect, works seamlessly if the Wi-Fi is good. But from a computer, videos, yeah, text, no. But would I recommend this thing? Because it's around $200 or €200. It depends on what you want to do with it. Do you want to watch full-on HD videos, action movies from Netflix with this thing? Nah, I wouldn't recommend it. Nah, not really. But if you want to watch YouTube videos with this thing just in your free time, or if you want to give presentations on your work, for example, and if you can arrange the lighting setup, because when there's a lot of lighting, you won't really see the screen that well. But if that's all good for you, well, then I would definitely recommend this thing, because it's actually pretty neat. Laying in your bed with a projector next to you and just laying like this and watching the screen, and it worked. So yeah, I dig that. That's actually pretty nice for the for this projector. Yeah. So if you want something to project your YouTube videos, if you consume YouTube videos during the evening, then I would definitely recommend this projector. It's very neat, it's very small. There are a lot of more options that I didn't show because I didn't have enough time to show them. So yeah, I would recommend them. Also, by the way, there are a lot of discount codes in the description for GearBest. They are coming out with a big discount festival or something like that, but all the information about that is down below, and it's especially for you if you want that discount when you're buying something. When you're buying something from GearBest. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like down below. If you didn't, leave a dislike down below and tell me why. And I hope I'll see you in our next video. Bye-bye.